Since I used the ampersand for the and, a logical and, I thought I'd do a little discussion on logical operators, and we'll cover some more of this again in another video. Most computer languages support the following logical operators: and, or, exclusive or, not. Sometimes some of the languages use XOR, or other ones will use EOR for exclusive or. It's not very often you'll ever see exclusive or used in software, unless you're doing something like error code validation with cyclic redundancy check characters, or maybe if you're doing cryptology, where you're really scrambling up characters so that it'll make it harder to recognize things and then decode it again. I'll tell you one thing about exclusive or, it's good to know it. It's one of the questions that happens to pop up in a lot of interviews, so even if you don't use it very often, you should know what it is, just in case you ever go for a job interview. In C, C++, and the curly brace languages, the logical and is represented by two ampersands, and the ampersand is like on the shift 7. The logical or is represented by two vertical bars, and that's over there by the enter key. Now, sometimes, depending on the font that you're using, there may be a little break in the vertical bars, or it may be a solid vertical line, so it can show up either way. The logical exclusive or is used with the caret. So two caret represent a logical exclusive or, and that's on the shift 6. Now you have to watch out because a lot of languages use the caret to mean exponents, like 2 raised to the power of 5. C and C++ don't have any exponents. You can do exponents with a math function, but it's not built into the language with an operator. The logical not is an exclamation mark, and that's right above the 1. So you have to do a shift 1 to get the exclamation mark for a logical not. Here is a truth table for the and, the or, and the exclusive or. Those three operators each have 2 inputs. With 2 inputs, there's only 4 possible combinations. I can have a false-false, a false-true, a true-false, and a true-true. Sometimes truth tables are represented with zeros and ones instead of trues and falses. So a 0 represents a false, and a 1 represents a true. It might be a little easier to see these with zeros and ones. Here is the truth table for the logical and. If both inputs are true, the output is true. I have to have input 1 true and input 2 true for the result to be a true. So if both inputs are true, the result is a true. Here's an example. I want to find out if it's a daytime charge between 8 in the morning and 6 at night. So I'll say if time is greater than or equal to 800 and time is less than or equal to 1800, then I'll do something. Both have to be true. One thing to look at here is I have to say time greater than or equal to 800 and time less than or equal to 1800. It won't work if I say, well, I can't just use an English expression and say if time is greater than or equal to 800 and less than or equal to 1800. I actually have to have it fully spelled out and do 2 full comparisons as part of my and. Another thing that makes it work out is the order of evaluation. It does the greater than or equal, or the less than or equal, it does those comparisons before it does the and. So if you remember in math, we had multiplication and division before addition and subtraction. So now we have something similar here to where we have the comparison operators. They will occur before the and. Next thing I want to look at is the truth table for the OR. If either input is true, the result is true. So if input 1 is true, the result is true. Or if input 2 is true, the result is true. Both of them are true, it's still true. Now here's the opposite test. For example, I could say, if time is less than 800 or time is greater than 1800. I'm testing to see if the time is before 8 o'clock or after 6 p.m. Then I have an evening rate. So this is the exact opposite of testing for the day rate. Notice that I'm using the comparison time less than 800 because I used greater than or equal 800 for the day rate. I'm testing time for greater than 1800, not greater than or equal, because I had less than or equal for my day rate. Here's the weird one, the exclusive or. If either input is true, the result is true. The only thing I can think of something similar might be the light switches in the hallway. So if you flip one of the switches up, the light goes on. If you have the other switch up, the light goes on. If they're both down, the light is off. One is up, light's on. Both up, light's off. Do you ever have a war with some other kid, you know, fighting them? Ah, turn it on, turn it off, turn it on, turn it off. I had that with the kids at home. The lights were flashing and flashing. Kids. I never was a kid. No, well, sometimes I think I'm just a grown-up kid. The logical not only has one input. Whatever comes in gets complemented. So if it's a true, then it's going to make the result a false. And if it was false, it's going to make it true. Every once in a while, we'll see that, maybe a little bit later. Bye-bye for now.